All right, ladies and gentlemen, good morning here from Cedar Rapids, Iowa. Adam Steele bringing you RollerHockeyLive.com's coverage of the 2016 National Collegiate Roller Hockey Championships. Here this morning we have one of the last Division II games in pool play, featuring the University of Massachusetts coming out in their Army-style sweaters. They'll be moving from right to left on your screen. On the other side, Robert Morris University. And they'll be in the orange and white sweaters moving from left to right on your screen. Got another Division II 4-on-4 contest here. We play three periods of 12 minutes apiece. As we keep moving along and finishing the pool play here, these teams will be seeded into the elimination bracket right after this game. Both these teams in a top pool. They should get a favorable seed each based on the finish of this game. Both these teams expected not only to be in the Sweet 16, but move up to the Elite Eight. They'll be on separate sides of the bracket, most certainly, as we get underway here. Robert Morris controls the draw. They'll have a little two-on-two moving forward, as this is Malley. Malley into the backhand. Burns, a defender, has a shot on goal. Save, and then he puts one off the side of the net, and welcome to the game there, goaltender for UMass. That's Jordan Davis, number 91. Shot on the other side from Daugherty, is a save there on that side by Harrison Wayne. Both goaltenders getting in the action real early here. We're just 35 seconds in to see two shots. Miscue on the play right there as UMass takes over. They'll wheel around with it as Wolsifer lays down for Daugherty. Daugherty inside, intercepted. He'll find his way back to a bouncing puck. Fire one in there, saved by Wayne. Robert Morris will take over. Both these teams very skilled in possession. Shot there goes wide off the stick of Malley. He's got a few attempts right off in the first shift of the game. Both these teams know how to control the tempo of a game. Two of our elite performers in Division II. UMass the runner-up last year. Wolsifer now with it for UMass. Daugherty's shot is going to be blocked in front. He'll find the bouncing puck on the rebound, throw across, and that went through everybody. We have a little battle here as UMass corrals back to Wolsifer. Wolsifer there, a little move there, now two-on-one opportunity. Getting pestered from behind. Puts it inside, and the shot by Daugherty. Didn't look like it went off the goaltender. He threw it right up to the mesh, so the faceoff will move up closer to the goal line. Just 2 minutes gone by here in the first. Zip, zip. And we thank you for joining us this morning on RollerHockeyLive.com. We thank you for tuning in from wherever you are. If you're in the Chicagoland area around Robert Morris University, or if you're in the New England area or Massachusetts area, we thank you for tuning in and cheering for your favorite college or university. Or maybe you're tuning in from another university or cheering for another university and you're watching to see what happens in this particular game, or if you're just a fan of the sport of roller hockey, we thank you for tuning in. My name is Adam Steele, and we're going to try and do our best for you here. We're calling lots of games here, and as I'm sure you can tell, the voice is running a little low on energy, but I'm still positive, I'm still passionate, I still got the heart to get through this, so we'll see. Keep going until I can't talk anymore. All right, UMass is going to set up behind their own net. They're going to throw kind of a home run pass. It looked like it deflected off of a glove and out of play. Actually, looks like it ended up in the UMass bench. So based on it going off of a Robert Morris glove, it'll still move to center rink because the deflection happened a little further down low in the zone. A little bobble there as Robert Morris did win the draw, but they're being pestered there. Now a two-on-two opportunity for UMass. And stepping in with a Carrier. Around the net with it now. Carrier turns inside. It goes off the pipe and into the corner. Couple one-on-one battles there. And the puck finds its way back down into the UMass zone. Oh, opportunity, a little break, sneaking past defense, a big save by Harrison Wayne. Coming fresh off, oh wow, nice defensive play there. As coming fresh off the bench was Gresser. And an opportunity, and there's another one. Puck was gonna go by and it was still waffled down by the goaltender Wayne. Now out to Carrier. Carrier sets, throws back for possession. This is Wolsifer. As they look to set up the right opportunity. Wolsifer skates it in all by himself. He throws it in the middle. And an opportunity was missed there by both squads. Goaltender Wayne sharp on his game. They'll play the puck back now as this is Aaron Marcel. Marcel getting his first touch on the puck here. Leading scorer for the University of Massachusetts. 43 goals the regular season in the ECRHA, 67 points. They'll throw a home run out for Daugherty. Daugherty in on a two-on-one. Trailer coming in, Wolsifer gets a shot blocked. Robert Morris looking, they got a trailer now for a three-on-two. Opportunity and a shot off the stick of Brad Bogus, goes high and wide. Robert Morris now. Tried to chip it behind, but it did not work. UMass will take over. They'll play it back for Marcel, and he's battling a falling Robert Morris player there as he comes away with the puck. He'll wheel back and look to set things up. And Robert Morris going for a change there of personnel. Wolsifer kind of fans on the pass attempt. And the Colonials will work out with it. Now a miscued play there is picked up by Daugherty from UMass. He's gonna miscue on the stick handle there. Opportunity turnover here for Trunk. Trunk's gonna fire, saved by Davis, rebound. He's gotta kind of sprawl to pick up that weak sauce. Couple excellent chances here. Both goaltenders standing the test. As we still got a 0-0 score, 6:30 left to go. First period. Draw controlled by Robert Morris. It's played across to Bogus, who's got a fire, tipped and scores! Not sure who that went off of. I don't think Davis kind of saw who it went off of either, but you got Robert Morris up, one zip. And we'll see who they give credit of the goal to in a moment. Either way, Robert Morris up by one to get it going. So UMass controls. They look to walk it up 3-on-3. And they'll keep possession, a race on for the puck now. Harrison will get there first out for Lapp. Lapp moves the puck inside. Rogantino's shot goes over the net. Colonials take over there. Step back with it for control. Rogantino again with a shot there. It sounded like they gave the goal to Bogus. We'll just make sure we have confirmation on that in a little while, but backhander in there, off the stick of Trunk, did not work. Rogantino will take for UMass and throw across. This is Broad. Broad with a shot high and wide. UMass needs to put one up on the board and they just keep seeming to miss the net. Sure, as the game goes on, things will get a little better. It's a highly skilled squad here from the state of Massachusetts. And just as we said, they need to put some shots on goal. Enter into the picture Tommy Gresser, who evens up the score, just quick-witted. The only thing you can say to that is, boom. I love when my telepathic ability happens to hit certain players. It's always nice. Stuff you want to see just happens. I love this game. Under 5 to go, first period. We got a tie score. Wow. Excellent play there by Carrier, using his strength and body just to gain a little position there and get the puck and be able to get a quick shot on. Anyway, opportunity for Robert Morris as they push in a bad angle shot there. They have to go back and get possession. So this will be Renner. He's going to move up the left wing side. A board battle ensues there as Walsifer takes it. He could have a 2-on-1 here with Carrier. Walsifer, I don't think he saw him. Opportunity now across for, I don't know, it's going to be played down there for Walsifer. Inside for Gresser, and a pad save there. And Wayne covers up. UMass not only getting a little more aggressive, but they're putting the puck on net. They take the lead in shots now at 5-3. 3:54 left to go, first period. Marcel's gonna try and control the draw, and he does. Turns for a shot, and it's blocked. Ladd now to take there for UMass. He's looking for possession. The puck deflects off the glass. A little board battle there as the puck's still behind the goal line. And Robert Morris will take over. They'll break up the right wing side as this is Hilderoff. Hilderoff now places it off of a defender's leg, and he'll battle behind the net. They'll be taken there, controlled by UMass as they play around for Lapp. Lapp will leave for Marcel. As they look to set things up, UMass very methodical. As a home run pass comes down for Darty, sneaking behind, 2-on-1, he's gonna shoot it off the iron. Puck's got enough strength to get around and boost Robert Morris up the floor. This is Dan Trunk, he's gonna drop it for Bogus. Bogus, a nifty move now, as he plays down low. Inside shot's gonna hit the outside of the net. Opportunity there for Benjamin, and he puts it on the wrong side of the netting. UMass taking over there in the form of Aaron Marcel. Marcel, see Lapp walk around. And now have a couple guys cycle. Darty in his famous spot up by the red line. Puck will get moved for Lapp. And he'll cycle back and look. Cross for Darty, who's been waiting over there on the far wing. Darty off the defender, finds its way to Baselli, and he can't handle it. Robert Morris has got a player down off of that rush, but he's getting back up and joining the play. Opportunity now for Trunk. He's going to step and fire through the defender's legs. And Davis saw that the whole way, and he'll make the stop. Now 2:06 remaining, first period. We still got a 1-1 game. Teams will change personnel. We'll set up for a draw all the way down on the far bottom right of your screen. UMass will win the draw as Rogantino chips it back. Walsifer now to push to the left side. Ryan Walsifer up for Broad, and unfortunately, a little miscommunication. It flies all the way down, but Kelly will get there first. Kelly across for the open Walsifer. Walsifer now, nifty little move. He's still got control. Looking for some open floor and time and space. Walsifer still holding. Looking to make the appropriate plays and not the mistakes. He leaves for Kelly. Kelly back for Rogantino, the touch to Walsifer. 3-on-2 opportunity. And to Rogantino, and a save by Wayne. Great play set up by UMass there. Now a lead pass could be a 2-on-1. An opportunity for Bogus. He's already got one. Oh, my Lord, a wide open net for Robert Morris's David Strager. And he put it wide behind the goaltender. Just another one of those he wish he could have had back. That was a tappy tap tapperoo. So Malley with it now. Robert Morris still has possession in the offensive zone. Malley does a giant circle and he comes back out with it again, and he's up at the top of the circle firing one wide. No pressure from Robert Morris as they look to change. And UMass with possession, they just gave it away with another home run pass. So back with it now, Helderoff, as he swings around. It's time for Trunk, and he'll move back behind his own net and set up a play for Robert Morris University. So Trunk walking all the way up through center. And in the final ticks, he throws one wide. So we'll end the first period here. Shots are 6-5 in favor of UMass, but the score, 1-1 after one. Great contest, Division II here on RollerHockeyLive.com. We'll take a break. Be back in a few moments. Adam Steele back here with you live from Cedar Rapids, Iowa. Thank you for tuning in to RollerHockeyLive.com's coverage of the 2016 National Collegiate Roller Hockey Championships. Here we're in the middle of a Division II contest. This is the end of pool play for these two teams. Last game, UMass in the desert camo. They're going to be moving left to right as they change ends on this particular period. Robert Morris in the orange and white. And they're moving right to left now. Second period action getting going. UMass again looking to set up a play from behind their own net. It makes its way out to Marcel on the right side. He turns towards center. He'll touch it over there for Harrison. Harrison runs into his own guy, but it gives to Darty. Darty threw a screen. The puck drops down in front. Opportunity for Marcel is patted aside easily by Harrison Wayne. Puck finds its way in front, deflected off a Robert Morris player, and they'll take over. Robert Morris, excuse me, now taking their time. Apparently they're looking to set up a home run play. Goes all the way down to the stick of Smeltzer. Smeltzer now touches for Bogus. Bogus on a weird angle, he's gonna fire it into Davis. Marcel takes over there for UMass. Oh, it gets weirdly deflected in front. Davis right there to hold on. So he'll have a little adjustment made to his equipment. And we'll have a face-off to his left-hand side. Just a minute change into the second period. Robert Morris will have an offensive zone opportunity. Both these teams, very impressive records coming into Nationals. Robert Morris came in with a 15-3 record in regular season play. UMass 16-2 in their respective conferences. So after UMass wins the draw, Walsifer will chip it up to Gresser on the right side. Gresser is going to turn in from his defensive zone and walk through the middle of the floor. Gresser going to fire one on, and the deflection was missed. A stop still made by Wayne. Opportunity around for Robert Morris as Trunk sends it back around. Pestered there is Helderoff, and he's going to move out. Helderoff touches across. Now this is Waxter. Waxter going to lose it to UMass. They'll pick up there in the form of number 21, Don Broad. Donnie Broad going to throw it ahead, and it's going to get a little too far for Gresser. Robert Morris will take over in the form of Trunk. Danny Trunk, number 19 for the Colonials. Going to hang out and survey the land. It's going to be left there for Nick Benjamin. Benjamin will walk through center and through two UMass players. And on the backhand, touches in front. Good defensive play and a stop by Davis. Davis out of his net, and he's going to look to make a play, and does. Puck's going to find its way to a couple players, and now on the stick of Carrier. Carrier pestered front and back, and Robert Morris will take over. Two-on-two rush, but some pesky back checkers await. Robert Morris on a change here is going to give up a little two-on-one. Walsifer walking in front. It's going to be deflected away as the pass from Broad didn't work out, and he'll go back for a change. So Robert Morris with no pressure really coming in. Now Marcel steps in. And Robert Morris will walk up the left wing side. Now through center, Malley. And an opportunity in front there. Almost converted by Strager. Nifty move to the backhand. But the play comes back around the corner. Opportunity here for Marcel as he tries to power through. He's going to send it into the middle. And there are no camo jerseys available. Robert Morris with an opportunity. Now here's Trunk. Ended up dancing through a couple people and moves the puck across for Malley with a shot. And it goes into the equipment of Jordan Davis, and we'll get another stop. Again, both goaltenders looking sharp here for both teams. Imagine another coaching little tweak that I would make is just telling these teams to capitalize on every opportunity in the offensive zone. Take as many shots as you can. The more shots you take, the more opportunity you're going to have to put it by a goaltender, especially on your short sides. If you take the shots on the short sides, these goaltenders will give up some rebounds. A play by Lapp. He's got a little mini break there all by himself, and he puts it into the pads of Wayne, and he makes a save in the middle now, chipped away by the Robert Morris defense. Lapp comes all the way back. He did a great job in there to keep possession for UMass. So it'll come all the way back on the stick of Marcel, and he'll wheel back and set up another play for UMass. Marcel looking. Still with it, very patient, looking for the right play. Don't want to give away possession. And now he'll leave it for Lapp. Lapp walks up the left wing side. He'll step around his defender and now go behind Wayne. Looking now, Lapp. Moves it down low. 3-on-3 opportunity there. Doherty shot on the short side, but wide. Opportunity on the backhand. Looked like it went off the goaltender's elbow there. Nice shot by Harrison. And no forecheck applied by UMass, so they did not pick the puck back up. Robert Morris does. Looks like they're going to send Bogus, and he's going to have the puck chipped away. Marcel tried to make a move, but he's got Lapp right there with him. Lapp top for the trailer. Darty with a shot. Nice save off the shoulder of Harrison Wayne. Again, both goaltenders standing tall. This will be a good contest all the way through. Aaron Marcel now. He's the leading scorer for UMass. Makes a smart play there as team's changing. Moves it outside for Ryan Walsifer. Walsifer makes a play taken by the defender, pushed around. They'll try and get possession again. And as the puck kind of stayed at everyone's feet there, everyone skated by. But Robert Morris take there, pestered by Marcel. He's going to pick it up now. Marcel tries to walk inside and on the backhand a little late. Marcel now picks up the loose puck. Turns, fires right into Wayne. Wayne's going to hold on. And he wasn't sure where it was, so he decided to step out of the net just in case it fell over and behind him. 5:48 left to play, second period here. Still a 1-1 score in this great hockey game here a Division II contest to close out this pool. So we'll have a face-off to the left. Robert Morris goaltender, Harrison Wayne. UMass is going to win the draw to Wolsifer. He'll step back and look for some space to make a play, and does. As he pushes it to Rogantino, Rogantino moves it down low. Opportunity in front, and another opportunity for Petruzzullo, but he's going to look for possession first. Blast by Rogantino goes wide. Opportunity here for Broad. Broad taking his time. He's got to settle the puck down first. Broad throws it. It's chipped off a defender. Robert Morris will push the puck to the corner. Petruzzullo there will forecheck, but to no avail. They already got rid of the puck. Stopped by the foot of Rogatino. He's got a two-on-two with Petruzzullo. Wolsifer trailing. Petruzzullo taking his time there. Sets it up top for Broad. Broad takes a shot. It deflects off the defender. Robert Morris will take over. Two forecheckers there as they throw the puck away. There'll be a race on for the puck. Looks like Wolsifer will get there first. Pestered there nicely, but he'll step away. Wolsifer now throws across. Glad with the shot, Wayne with the save. He'll be chipped up a little too short. Opportunity for a break there as Rogantino throws it down to Petruzzullo. Goes off his stick. Petruzzullo throws behind the net. Inside now for Rogantino, sticked away by Wayne. Robert Morris sent a guy long, but UMass cut off yet another Robert Morris pass. Puck will stay in their zone. Opportunity in front, a little chip. Wayne got over for the pad save. Another Robert Morris pass, almost picked off there. He'll send another player, but it goes too far, and Baselli will take over and set it up for UMass. Now ahead for Carrier. He's got room. He's going to fire. Five-hole and score. Nolan Carrier putting UMass up by one with 3:48 left to go second period. That's all you got to do, folks, is put it on net. You never know what's going to happen. Carrier does so. Now him and Gresser both have markers. And the lead. Face-off win by Marcel. He's going to rush to the net. Opportunity for Daugherty is a save by Wayne. And no one knew where that one went, so I guess it flew out into the crowd. Yet another great souvenir here, courtesy of the NCRHA. Robert Morris wins the draw here. 3.5 to go, first period. They're going to look to get one back. Oh, speeding through there was Malley, but he plays it back. He's going to look to get it back, but no, he leaves it there. Robert Morris sends a home run pass all the way down there off of Strager. Strager can't control as Daugherty's there for UMass. Daugherty pestered by Malley, and Robert Morris takes over. Now chipped ahead by Malley on the left wing side to walk through center. Delay, but then put a shot on. And as Davis saw it the whole way, he'll glove it down and get a face-off to his left. All right, just under 3 minutes to go here, second period. That 2-1 lead for UMass still holding up. Offensive zone opportunity for Robert Morris, and they win. Puck comes between the two defenders, and it's picked up there by Bogus. Bogus, little nifty backhander in there just wide. He'll get his own rebound, and he'll move across just a little too far for Renner. Renner will battle for the puck and wins. Throws across for Bogus, right along the red. He'll go back to Renner. Renner with a shot high and off the glass. Marcel will scoop there for Massachusetts. Marcel makes a move. It's intercepted. Now UMass will pick up and go the other way. This is Ladd with a shot. Excuse me, that was Broad. Wayne did make the save, however. Now he tries to throw inside for Darty. Carrier will pick it up and miscue. Walsifer scoops it up. Now for Carrier. Carrier back for Walsifer as UMass resets. Walsifer tried to chip it ahead with no luck. Gets his own rebound off the defender and walks in. Three on one, Walsifer drive, and it goes over the net. Now the puck finds its way all the way back to Darty. Darty shot high and wide, a rebound scores! He threw it high and wide off the glass, and Johnny on the spot, I believe, was Donnie Broad. Just happened to be sitting there back door, and the puck just seems to find his tape. And he'll put it in to give UMass a two-goal lead. Sure, Mel Allen would be saying, how about that? And most players are probably saying, well, better lucky than good. Either way, UMass has that score at 3-1 now. Harrison walking up with it, and that'll be gloved down as Harrison Wayne will stop play this time. So far, if he's seen it, he could stop it, except for that one, which would still have the score even. UMass finding any way they can to get one by him. And they win the draw again. Harrison will shoot it. It'll chip off a defender and behind the net. Now we'll get chipped around to Waxter. Waxter will walk through center with it. Waxter stepping through a couple defenders and Pester. They'll go all the way to the backboards. They'll battle for it against two UMass players. It'll get chipped to the corner now. Battle for it won by Walsifer. He'll chip to the outside there and it'll be taken. A little two-on-two action. Shot in on Wayne. Is a save. And unfortunately, while shooting, Gresser ended up falling down, but put everything he could on it and he'll go get a change. So UMass, another offensive draw. They've had a lot of them. Under a minute to go, second period. Let's see what happens on this one. They win it again. It's touchdown by Harrison. Rogantino in the corner, a little deflection in front, and it just squeaks by the goalie. Opportunity again in front, Rogantino on the back door. It doesn't reach him. He's getting pestered, so he one-hands it to the far corner. Another board battle there. The puck comes around. Petrozzullo now. And now Rogantino across for Harrison. Back for Rogantino. Nice defensive play. RMU now with 20 to go. Opportunity and a shot blocked by the defender and he falls over. That looked like it hurt. And Baselli getting pestered from front and back. He's gonna throw the puck down behind goaltender Wayne. And as you heard there, he's just killing off the last couple seconds. So we're going to take a break here on RollerHockeyLive.com, and we'll be back in a moment with third period action. 3-1 UMass.
Really?
All right, ladies and gents, Adam Steele back here with you from RollerHockeyLive.com's continuing coverage of the 2016 National Collegiate Roller Hockey Championships. Here we're third period action now in this Division II pool play contest. Teams are back at their bench sides, UMass in the desert camo, and Robert Morris in the orange and white. UMass won the opening draw as they're going to swing a couple players there by the red. And Aaron Marcel will swing all the way around and back. And the puck will move from Daugherty up to Marcel. It's intercepted there by Bogus. Bogus will step in. He's got a man in front. Sticked in, rebound, and another try. Three total. And two of them have to be stopped by Davis. So we'll see a draw to his right in the opening 35 seconds here of the third. UMass has the 3-1 advantage. Also leading in the shot department, 20-10. And a miscue off the backboards, and Davis sprawling. The puck ended up hitting him. 2-on-1 rush now for Marcel Daugherty. Marcel Daugherty, Wayne got over for the save. So the Colonials will look and push the puck over left. Tried to get it ahead and it was chipped a little too far for one, a little too short for another, and UMass will come back as this is Ryan Walsifer. Walsifer finds a guy behind, everybody shoots and scores. Talk about being in the right place at the right time twice, that's Donnie Broad. Broad, a little bit of extra effort, a little bit of hard work, never hurt anybody, and he's doing it here for UMass. He's got the last two goals. They say if you wear 14, you're twice as lucky. You wear 21, that's three sevens. And right now he's got two goals. Not sure how all that works together, but I was a math guy and I still can't figure out what I just said. Anyway, UMass yet wins another draw. They'll push the puck up to the left side as this is Buscelli. He'll move all the way back behind his own net with 10 to go. They got a 3-goal lead. Pass up a little too far for Carrier, but looks like he could be the first one in the race to get it. He does. He'll walk around the net and look. He'll play it all the way back now, as that's a safe play. Keep possession. So the puck finds its way all the way back to Carrier as they cycle all the way around. Carrier touches it back, and there's a race on now. Harrison will get there first and leave back for Buscelli. Buscelli across now finds its way back to Gresser. Gresser stepping outside, got a shot off as he was being sticked by the defender. So Robert Morris will move out. This is Benjamin. Nick Benjamin now walking through. Steps on the right side and goes down. Looks like he blew out a tire. So chipped away as a one-on-one battle ensues back there, and it'll get pushed up. Now on the left side with it, the puck will move to center. A little two-on-two action as Walsifer will take behind the net. Touch it in front. Wayne's stick is there to make a stop. And Robert Morris is going to throw the puck all the way back. This is Trunk. He'll set up behind his own net and give. Up the right wing with lots of speed is Kevin Malley. Taking it all by himself all the way into the far corner, and he's going to push the puck out. A shot by Hilderoff goes wide. So UMass throws a pass up, intercepted now. Taken by Trunk. Trunk looking. Gonna try and find some space, and he walks around. Pestered on two sides now, he's gonna hold the puck. Tries to walk around the defender to no avail. It'll get moved back up top for Hilderoff. Hilderoff now gonna touch across. Opportunity for Malley, he's gonna push down. Push down to Strager. Strager pushes all the way down low. Battling there for it is Trunk. He'll lose the battle and UMass will take over. They're going to push ahead for Petrozulo. Petrozulo one against two and can't slide it by the defender. Petrozulo will tap across now. Opportunity going to be passed back and unfortunately to an orange jersey, not a camo jersey. Excellent try there by Rogantino, but it didn't work. And a Robert Morris play deflected off of Walsifer. Davis followed it the whole way. So as he covers, we'll see a draw to his right. That'll be on the top right of your screen with 7:29 left to go in the third. So Massachusetts, after winning the draw, is going to push up for Marcel. Marcel walking, looking for space, and he'll have a shot blocked. He'll still get his own rebound and walk in on the backhand. Now into forehand. Couldn't work in against three orange players. I wonder why. Robert Morris University will take over from there. They're down by three. They need to hurry. Home run pass played along. We'll have a battle for the puck. Looks like it was won by Harrison. He's going to play it around the left wing boards. Half-court battle there won by Robert Morris. Stepped inside and pestered a shot by Bogus, also gets blocked. Lapp has it there. He's going to try and move it behind the net. Wins the battle there, and the puck is all the way played to the right wing side. And as Daugherty walks all the way across the rink, he's going to walk all the way back across the rink and leave it back. That'll get touched and come back to Lapp now. Couple battles going on the offensive side. Everybody jockeying for position as UMass works the puck up. Daugherty, three on three. He's going to step around his player with a nice move and a shot. Going to be blocked as a couple players went diving to sacrifice their bodies. Davis is going to help Lapp there. He'll watch his guy go by, and he'll walk the puck up the floor. Now across for Broad. Broad plays all the way across, and it gets a skate deflection back. Now on a shot, and on Wayne, he'll stick it aside. Broad pressuring now, good forecheck, as Robert Morris will look to step out. They do and work through center. Here's Bogus, he's gonna have it taken away. So this will be Marcel. Tries to step through two defenders again, and a weak pass or a weak play ends up in on goal. Wayne will make the stop, and the Colonials move up floor. Shot, not sure if it hit anything or might have deflected up into the protective mesh. Looks like it'll be off a UMass player either way, and the faceoff will stay inside. 4:49 left to go. Third period, 4-1 in favor of UMass. Another one deflected straight up in the air. This time it'll stay on the playing surface and find its way up to Gresser. Gresser walks on the left wing side around his man and into the chest of Wayne. He'll hold on. Shots on goal department in favor of the current victors right now. 25-12. UMass will win the draw, but it's quickly scooped up there by Malley. Malley, three on three, is going to try and work the puck over. Gets his own rebound and throws in a late shot as Davis had to kick it away with the toe at the last second. Opportunity here for Carrier. A little mini breakaway, roofs it. Sneaking behind his man right there, Carrier. with his second of the game. Most people need a ladder to get up there, but he knows how to roof it. Looked like there's going to be a timeout taken by the Colonials. So with that timeout, we'll also take a timeout here on RollerHockeyLive.com. We'll be back for the conclusion of the third period in just a moment. Back on RollerHockeyLive.com here. Coming up on 4 minutes left to go. UMass up 5-1. Two goals by Carrier, two goals by Broad. And the one for Gresser, that equals 5. The lone tally by Robert Morris comes from Brad Bogus, number 76. Petruzzulo's shot sticked away by Wayne, goes to the left wing boards. Now by the benches, Wolsifer. He'll tap it ahead. Puck will find its way up and over for Petruzzulo. 3-on-2. Petro in front. He chips to Kelly. Kelly chips it over Wayne, and they got another one. Kelly taps in a little chili dipper, and it'll be 6-1 now. Where's Andrew Kelly been all game? I think that's the first time I've said his name. He's been hiding in the weeds all game, I guess. But either way, picked some great timing, picked a great spot, and chipped one in for the University of Massachusetts. So Petruzzulo now. He'll wheel around the net. Makes a safe play all the way back to Baselli. They'll maintain possession. Baselli across the floor and asks for it back. He'll get it back off the far back boards. Now UMass being pressured by two Robert Morris University jerseys. And a miscue by UMass will see the puck flown all the way down the floor. So to pick up there, Hilderhoff now to move to the right wing side. Now moving across the floor is Trunk. Trunk's gonna dump it there for Malley. Malley misses. And a two-on-one opportunity. Alley's going to hurry back, try and stop him. Kelly sneaks behind everybody again, and this time his chili dipper goes wide. Opportunity for Malley again here. Throws in a bouncing puck, and Davis had it eyed all the way. Snares it with the glove, and he'll have a draw to his left. 2.25 to go, third period. UMass just outpowering Robert Morris with every maneuver. And as you heard there, Robert Morris is still verbally disappointed. So Marcel now, he's gonna walk around his man. Little backhander in front, and it was stopped by the defender. Now another battle there, as Marcel pick it up on the half boards. Marcel patiently looking. Marcel drawing two orange jerseys, he throws it back. Again, Massachusetts being very safe with the puck today, making the appropriate plays and using the entire 200 by 85 surface. They were the national runners-up last year in this division. They show why. Marcel watched by two, stopped by a third. All these teams, no matter what, still keying on Marcel no matter what point in the game. Darty's shot is a save by Wayne. Their shot total goes to 29. Marcel steps around his man, and he's got room. He's going to fire a shot. Wayne has to turn aside yet another. Opportunity now for Lapp as a battle down low. Sees the referee raise his arm. And apparently, we have, I believe, what will be our first penalty of the game. Apparently, the battle got a little rough down in the corner. And Marcel gave him a little no-no. So he'll sit down for 2 minutes. I guess Marcel a little frustrated. He's normally a couple point a game player, and he's been held completely off the score sheet. So I guess it's a good way to get on the score sheet. Take yourself a penalty. So coming upon a minute left to go, Robert Morris will get some power play practice. I guess UMass will get some PK practice here. So a nice battle around and turning with it there is Carl Renner, and it's going to be stopped yet again by Davis. So with 49 seconds left of special teams practice here for both teams. And the draw is officially won by UMass, a little deflection up towards the red line. And nice little board battle there, and coming away with it is Dan Trunk, but then it's taken away by UMass. They'll look as Petrozzullo plays it back. They'll shift back with it now as, is that Marcia Shelley? That's the first time I've said his name today too. Guess getting his first minutes out there today. His long bench by UMass, 15 seconds left to go. Opportunity again as the shot off of Trunk's stick was blocked. He's still got his own rebound. He's still got the puck. He's going to fire it in, a save there. And as the puck is played away, the fat lady is entering the surface. UMass 6, Robert Morris 1. That's a closeout pool play for Division II for these two teams. Impressive showing by last year's National Division II runners-up. UMass a contender again this year. We'll see how they do as the brackets get started up. So as these two teams will fall into their particular area of the bracket, we encourage you to tune into ncrha.org and click on Division II. You could see the brackets in real time. A lot of updates will be done on Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram. It's all there. Just search NCRHA, and if you Twitter fans out there are looking to trend some topics, it's hashtag NCRHA Natties. So I'm Adam Steele here for RollerHockeyLive.com. We're going to close out this broadcast, but stay tuned here for RollerHockeyLive.com on both rinks for the rest of the coverage, and we'll see you again real soon.